Yeah, wow. All right, let's start with sit up down together. Just a second. All right, let's start with a sit up down together. Good. All right, stand. Okay. In out. Soft. Punch. Beats out. Hands out. Okay, in out. Hooks out. Breathe. Hooks out. Breathe out. Hooks out. Hands up and change to hands up, feet, hand back, same on the other side, hands up, right in the middle, one fist away from your chest, there you go, and then you turn to wings up. Good. Bring your hand back right to the center. Okay, make sure your elbow is focused, your wrist is relaxing. And then when you drop your hooks out, focus on the elbow, connect to your hip, your wrist is about to be relaxed, soft. So the wrist out again. And back in. And then drop down the hooks out. Connecting your elbow and your hip. Yeah, wrist will be stay relaxed. Okay, last time. In out. Good. Okay, from here, hands out. And hip. Circle, bring it back. Okay, gums out, straight on the sides of your body. Move to the back, really close, strike back, put your elbow on your wrist. In front, straight forward. Good. Lands out, form the elbow on your hip. Chop, both sides. Bring it back. And then drop to the front. Good. Turn down to jut. And then slide forward with your elbow, beauty. And then you circle soft. All right, then loose your hand, bring your hand. Good, open your hand, circle, bring it back. A bit faster. More soft and relaxed, again. Yeah, again. Mm-hmm. One more time. Okay, in the form it's only one time, but it, because we did not do the warm up, so with our system, we use this one, we do five times, okay? To make you loose and fast, okay? In the form is only one time. Okay, last section. Middle of your packs out. Block, block, straight. Circle. Bring it back. Block, block, straight. Bin 6 Than 6 Gan 6 Than Circle your wrist, strike to the rib cage. Good. Bring your hand back. Than Gan Than Bin 6 Strike to the rib cage. Back. Bop. Elbow, hit. Circle. Bop. Elbow, hit. Circle. Hands out. Right in the middle. Push and pull. Three punch. Take your hand in. Step up. There you go. Okay, good. Did Carol learn the first part of Chum Kiru to Carol? The first part of the second form? Did we learn that right? Okay, we go together on that second form slow. Chum Kiru, Chum Kiru. Carol can follow along. That's the same. Stand open the same. Okay? This part the same. Gan Sao, up, same. Okay, the punch goes straight into the center. Circle. With your left, first, always with your left first. And then when you circle, you pull and punch with your right. Circle. Good. Both hands like this, push, straight, side straight forward, sideways, side strike. So we aim, hit, right there, right to the neck with that one. Good. From here, you fall into this position, we turn left. Right, left, bring your hand out, both hand out, elbow drop, good, your opposite side with your leg falling in first, one, two, three, turn this way, one pull, one strike, one, two, and three. Okay, I think Carol stop there. Did you do this? Elbow pull to the other side? No? Okay, then you stop there. Okay, bring your hand back to the front. Just look in. Good. Come to the side. Bring your box out to the front. Come to the side. And box out, push to the front. Good. Turn back this way. Make your fist. Pull and punch. Chop, fax out, bring your hand back, in front, fox out, take this hand, yeah, good, turn your hand, circle, take it back. Same on the other side, both hands straight, sideways, hit, drop, your right on top, turn right, left, right, extend your hand out and forward, elbow drop. Fold it in. One, two, three. Just sour and strike. One, two, three. Bring your hand to the other side, elbow. Now bring your hand right to the front. One, that way. Two, right in front. This way. Three, push. This way. Move your fist right here, pull and punch, chop, fax out, back to the front, fox out. Good. Take this hand, pull down, and push, and circle, take it back. Second part, hand from here, turn, low kick, bomb, arrow can look, drop, both hand, bomb, block, drop hand. Third time, turn to a strike, back to the front, take this hand, pull, and push, take your hand, in out, take your right hand, turn, kick, low kick, bomb, drop, two, drop, three, pull strike, back to the front, take your hand, down strike, pins out, back. Third section, turn, low kick. Okay, both hand, low box out. 2. Low ball 6. Up 3. Low ball. Dive hit 6. Circle hit. Push. Circle. Hold back. Turn. Kick. Low ball. Tap 6. Low ball. Double. Here. 3. Double elbow push. Double hand. Circle. Push. Beat 6. Hold back. Hold it. Hold it. Jonathan beat him kick out again. Hold it. Second. There you go. Hand back from here. Now we turn to the front and then from here, throw in the kick. Again, go. Gum 6. Gum 6. Gum 6 block. Yes. We'll turn to strike. 2, 3. Take the hands in. Step up. Okay. Put the hand down. Okay. Before I let you do a no count, okay, just go back, reinforce the meaning a little bit, and then you get to no count. Okay. In Chung Kyu. In Chung Kyu, introduce us, we're starting using your hip in the fight. You notice that, right? It's a lot of them now. We're not going to stay there and bring your hand, but we'll turn. You turn. You turn. If people come and push us, we're not going to resist them. You're going to use the body to move them, right? That's why in the form you see this. Elbow. Elbow. So the force come at us, we don't fight with them, but we redirect them, okay? So he go and he push here. I feel he's heavy on this side. We don't fight back. We use your body to turn them. So now they're supposed to be go this way, yeah? Those elbows mean like that. I go fight. They go, they push this way. So if they push this, we turn this way. If they push this way, we turn that way, right? So that's why you have the Chung Kyu meaning like that, right? It meaning to push him with the elbow and then we can hit them. So now you see the form have this part, yeah? Meaning like that. Okay? Yeah. Yeah? If they put you on the center, okay? They put right to the center, so then we move it, right? Then now you gotta use it your legs, right? Okay, so if you put the center, we can don't fight with them, but you move your legs, now we use your leg to push them, right? So it's just like that. In Wing Chun, idea of Wing Chun, if we hit them, but we don't resist them. We don't resist them. Because if you resist a person who's stronger than you, we have a problem, right? Our job is, if he put your hand, he plays the hand to your chest. I mean, we normally, if somebody push you, you push him back. It's not smart, because if he's stronger, we're not gonna win them, right? He push, I move him, and then I hit them, right? That's why Chung Kyu teach you to be like that. If somebody wrap here, we're gonna move them to this side, and then we hit them back, right? We're not gonna be trying, he push you, you push him back. It's now, second time he's stronger, he's gonna push you a lot harder, right? So Chung Kyu teach you to be like that. Move him to the side, and then hit them, okay? Now this elbow also right here, we use it in that one application. Application number 2 is when you have a lapda. I go, I block, I punch him. That person now raised their hand to block. Now I was stuck. I'm about to punch him and then they blocked it with a heavy hand. So from the block, we turn to arm break. Yes? Yes? There you go. So I go and he blocked and he resisted. So we don't try to force them, we turn to this. Same move. That you see in the form that use your hip to turn. So I do lapda, they resist it, we turn to the arm break. But this arm break is not using like a karate shoulder, okay? They use it stuck, use your hip to turn. This why now they hurt more, right? That also in the form. So why you see the form have this? It have to be using your hip and your elbow, okay? Nothing about shoulder, there's no shoulder in there, okay? And then when you turn it, you have the move go like this, and then elbow drop. Turn, drop the elbow. This elbow drop also used a lot in the fight. And say somebody go, and I blocked it, he wrapped my hand, and he started punched down to the rib cage. He wrapped your hand, and he stretched your hand like this. Can you take your hand and block if he hit you? No way you can take your hand down, is it? Because he pull your hand, stretch it, he punch you, or he kick you. So if you try to do like this, it's gonna fight with him, right? So what happened is we don't fight like that. All we do is just a little sinking. A little bit sinking with your elbow. Yeah? We don't fight with them, okay? Can you, what else? Here, give me a second. I block it in.
If we fight with them, we cannot using the force against that person. Okay? So, and that's why in the forum teach not using any strength, but using your elbow only. That's why the form you see this. Elbow only. Elbow only, right? It's like that. It just as quickly using this and bring your elbow down just a little bit, enough for you to block, right? So that's why you see the form have this, elbow drop. Is that right? Here, elbow drop. Yeah, that little drop, also important. Okay? And then from the drop, you have the breaking hand technique. One, two, three. One, two, three. This technique meaning like that. The person go wrap the neck, you hold hand, and you hit. If you only just hit one hand, they're not strong enough. So we're actually using one push down and one push up, right? So he wrap the shoulder, we're gonna move up, and we use one hand on his hand, one hand we lift. Okay, so now his hand now meaning stretch your elbow. So he wrap you, you move back and you do this, right? So your hand, his hand will be like this. And from the stretching the arm, you go to the arm break. So I do this and then I go to the arm break, yes? So the guy go wrap you from there, you raise the hand, he wrap his shoulder, okay? Then the same hand with his hand will go underneath his elbow, like this. And the back hand presses on his hand. So this is what we want. We go to the arm break. That's it. So this move we'll use it later on when we learn those. Okay? Jump kill. Learn a lot of breaking arm lock, and that's why we have that in jump kill. One, two, three. Okay? And then you have this. Pull, hit him. One, two, three. What that one teaching you? What that one trying to do? If you in front of the person and you hit him, he will block. You hit again, he block. You hit this, he block, like in karate block. There's no way for you to hit him, right? So what happened to Wing Chun saying, when I hit him, he blocked, I pull down, I hit again. He blocked it, pull down, hit. And that's why we have one push down, one hit, one push down, one hit, one push down, one hit. This way, the guy cannot even fight back, right? So that's why you see the form have that. One, two, three. All right, then you have, okay, from here you got lance out. One, two, three, lance out. Bong out, lance out. Yeah? What does that do? Bong and lance out. What is that two elbow doing in a fight? That two elbow we use a lot in chi sao. Whoever learned chi sao will learn this. Let's say we get to a little bit fight. His force right now is on my elbow, right? I'm blocking his force right here. So if you hold your hand and you try to resist his push, we're gonna have a problem, because if he pushes it in, we fight like this, we're gonna be stuck. So we don't try to bring your shoulder and your elbow to hold it. All we need to do is just elbow, okay, in the form, elbow, bombs out, and your hip. All right, if he push this, he push over here, don't fight back. Let it collapse and hit him with the back hand. Yes? Yes? So if he push here, he push this, collapse this, okay? He puts this, you collapse this, elbow on top of his head, we hit them with the back hand, yes? There you go. If he push this to this way, then I turn this way. Now his forces go here, we hit them with the back hand, and then we hit them again, right? So in the form Cham Kiu, you notice that they teach you after one, two, three, turn. From the turn, they teach you two. If the force, somebody push the force this way, we let them go this way. Yeah? Yeah? If push here, we let them go here. We hit them with the back hand. How do you hit? It doesn't matter. You can hit them by punching. You can hit them by palm. You can hit them by drop the hand and give them a chop to the face. Bomb like that, right? So this means like that. Have a hand walk. He push here, I let it collapse. I hit them. I let it collapse. I fax out chop them. I let it collapse. I'm elbow them. So all the move, it doesn't matter the technique, but the matter is where do he push? He push here or he push here? If he push here, then you do this part in the form. So the form have turn and have a turn left and turn right, right? Yeah? If they push here, don't fight with him. Then you turn this way. Then you turn this way. When you turn this way, he's over here to hit. So that's why you have bombs. So this way, you have this way. In the form, you have that to one side, this to the other side. Now you understand the form now, right? Why they have that? They have one over here, hit them, And one over here, hit them, right? So go back, you see the form. One, this, this, this. They teach you like that. So we learn to move. Of course, you don't let the person push your arm to your body like this, you get hit. He push here, I turn here. He push here, I turn here. So you know that Eunchum gives all about that. Just him like an elbow when Francesco asked me before. Where do he push? He push here, I turn here. He push here, I turn here, right, Francesco? So this is an elbow sideways, and this is another one. He push here, we do this. He push here, we turn this, we hit that. Same idea, same idea. Chum kill mean you use your body, and you turn away his force. We don't want to fight with them. So this is that, use an elbow to turn. Use an elbow to turn. So you have a form here, 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 here. Yeah, that's what I mean. From here, take the punch, pull and punch. Chop and fox out and take your hand, do this, right? Okay, so after you gotta turn now, and you have your hand from here, take this hand, put it here, pull and chop. What does that mean from there? Pull and chop, what does that mean? What the application of that move? Right, they teach you one concept. You go through a little bit of the hand fighting, and then that person wrap your hand. He wrap your hand. If you punch him, he wrap your hand, you punch him, he also can punch you back, right? So what happened is Wing Chun say, listen, when you hit him, this hand cannot stay here. If they stay still, I hit him, he punch me back. So they said, the guy wrap you, you pull him. You pull him, you punch him. So this way, when you pull him, he fall forward, and you punch him with the other hand, right? That's why the moves like this. One hand pull him in, one hand punch him, look. Like that. One hand pull him in, one hand punch him. Right? So he got my hand. Okay? I pull. I'm pulling. Use a hip to pull. He will fall forward. So when he fall forward, we hit them with the back hand. We elbow them back with the front hand. So we can hit them in an elbow. That's why you see the form like pull and punch. Pull and punch. Right? Pull and punch. So if, let's say, Carol not finished the form, at least when you not understand the application, all you do like that. Keep your hand up front. Alright, and learn to be this. One hand pull, one hand hit. This hand pull, this hand punch. The guy hold your hand, pull, punch. This is how you apply and you practice your chum ki, right? You don't just do the form, you have to do the move and with the meaning. So in the form you have that, elbow pull in, punch him. Elbow pull in, punch him, yes? That's what it means. Alright, and from the punch you have a fox out chop. There's no application on this. It just remind you the practice of chop from Silom Tao, right? Silom Tao have a chop, chop. So now Chum Kiu go back, practice the chop again, but now it's one hand. So you see this is the same with Silom Tao, and you have this. The same again in Silom Tao, we have the chop, and then you have Fok Sao, yes? Okay, so run and form the chop, and here, you go back to Fok Sao, okay? So they teach you, okay, don't forget Fok Sao and Silom Tao. Fok Sao means when you're catching it, you use an elbow to block the person, okay? There's a lot of people don't understand it. When you put the fox out, you make it like a hook and you hold it hard. And nobody fight with the hook cannot fight, okay? You just lose your hand and then bring your elbow in front like this. This is called fox out, yeah? Elbow and block him. So from here I hit, the person punch forward, I bring my elbows in and I stop the attack. That's what the fox out mean. From here, he punching, we move the elbow into a block, yes? And your hand loose, that's called fok sao, yeah? So, people don't do it from here, they just bring your hand down like this. It's not gonna fight like this, nobody gonna fight with your wrist like this, okay? But, that's why in the form here, you quickly to bring back your elbow to the middle, in the fok sao, that's where the form is. And then take the hand, do this, yeah? There you go. So this is the application of chum kiu, right? Pull, hip pun. Chop him, fok sao to the front, take your hand, do this. Bin sao, take the hand back, yeah? Yeah, so when you do the forearm, you must have the meaning in your head like that, okay? All right, it's good. This three, I need you to do a beauty form, okay? And Carol go back on chum kiu form with me, okay? Carol go with me chum kiu. This three go beauty, follow Ben, okay Ben? Beauty, follow Ben. Here you go. Me and Carol do chum kiu one more time. Okay, chum kiu again. Both hand back in, stand open, same. Punch.
Punch straight in front. Circle punch. Circle. Back. Good. Straight down hand. Straight forward. Head straight. Good. Drop. Left hand on top and turn left. Elbow. Two. Three. When you turn, make sure your weight in the back so we turn easier. Okay? Forward. Hand forward outward. Elbow drop. And then you fold your hand in. One, two, three. Good. You turn this hand, one hand pull down, one hand strike. One, two, three. Turn to this elbow. Good. From this elbow, you slowly turn both hands to the front, Bob. Yeah, no, 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 no. Your hand down. The elbow there, turn to this. Right hand, right hand, right hand. When you do this, you're on the right hand. Yes? Take that elbow, turn to the front. Yeah? Yes! There you go. There you go. So from here, when you turn to the front, the back hand is also out like this. Good. Back hand. Good. Then turn to the side. Repeat that move. Turn to the side. No. In the front, take that elbow, move to the side. Yes? Hand back here. And then repeat it again. Same hand, move back to the front. Yes. Same hand, he push here and move to the side. There you go. That way. Good. Repeat it one more time. And turn to the side. Yeah, did. Take this punt, put it close to the elbow. Good. Close to the elbow. Pull your hand, elbow back, and punch. To the face, no, 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 no. Right hand, left, left punch, punch with your left. Punch with your left. Turn around, chop with your left. And back to the front with your left. Yes. With your elbow bend, one punch away from your chest, good. Take the other hand and do gaps out. That's it. Turn your hand, bottom, pins out. Bottom hand, pins out, take it back. How's that, Darren? Good? Good? Okay? Good. Ben's good? Jonathan and Jesco, good? Alright. Self-training. Okay, Karen, do that again by yourself. See if you can do that part we just did, right? Alright. Okay, hump jump from here. Hump jump from here. Ben and Jonathan can go by yourself. One. All the way, okay? I checked Francesco. Okay, Francesco was section 6, 7. Huh? 7, okay. Francesco need to show 7. Which one 7?
Just part 7?
No, now it's 7. 7. Yeah? Yeah? Bob? Pull, jump. Hit. Forgot. Yeah? Pull. Chop, fax out, hit. Good, bomb, pull, chop. What is that? 7, Francesco. Section 7. We're not done yet. Bomb,
yeah.
Wrap, pull, strike. Both yeah. Sides. Okay, try again.
Yeah.
Yeah, left and right. Good.
Yeah.
And then bomb. Step, leg together, strike. Bomb, strike. Strike? Yeah. Bomb, turn back, strike. And then step forward to the other side. Bomb, same thing, strike. Cancel. Pins out. And pull and strike. That's it. There you go. And close the form. Double jut. Double toes out. There you go, Francesco. Good. Practice is that. I see Ben and Jonathan. Yep. Or if you kind of forget, follow Ben. Ben do one more section 7 with Francesco so he can look at that, go slower. Yeah. Go. You follow Ben. Follow Ben. Good. Good, good, and good. All right. Yeah. Good.
Yep.
Good. There you go. That's it. Good. Mm-hmm. Yeah, no. Just go stop at section 7. Okay, good. Alright. Jonathan go with Francesco 1 to 7. Okay? Francesco follow Jonathan 1 to 7 hump jump. Okay? Bend on y'all. Yeah, hump jump. Take your time. Okay, Carol, are we remember the move yet? Yeah? This one open same like cylinder. The stand open like cylinder. The front part here exactly like the cylinder. Okay, pull back. Same with cylinder. Now the punch, it's just straight into the center. You do the circle. You pull and punch. Yes. That's good. You do block, straight forward. Good. Drop hand. Your left hand on top, then you turn. Good. Make sure anytime you turn, you have to shift the weight and then you can turn easy. Yes? Yeah? The weight shift to the back, heavy from the back, then you can turn very easy. Good? Alright? And now from there, you go extend it. Okay, left, you drop the elbow. You're gonna do 1, 2, 3. And you do jut and strike. 1, 2, 3. Yeah? Then you turn right hand. When you're right, so you pull your right elbow. Your right elbow. Yeah, your right elbow. No, which one is your right elbow? Which one is your right? Yeah, your right. And you pull this way. You pull. Yeah? From here, turn. Okay? Yeah? So your right here. Here is your right. Your right elbow like this. Your right elbow like this. So if I'm facing the mirror, we face the same direction. From here, Carol, we'll turn left. Yes! You turn. And then you turn right again. You're right, yeah? Turn left, turn right. Good. Turn left, turn right. So the idea of the form, it teaches you anytime the force push here, I turn left, the force push here, I turn right, right? They teach you like that. Good. One more time. Turn left, turn right. Move your fist right to your elbow. Pull this hand back, punch across to the face. Same hand in the front, turn to fast chop. And move your hand to the front. Move your hand to the front, folks out. Yeah? Good. Yes. And take the other hand, do this. There. Good.
Left on top first.
Pull.
Push.
Yeah?
Put my camera on the other side.
Good. And then take your hand, open hand, beans out. That's it, yeah, Carol? So don't worry about memorize the form. Form, I can send you the clip. You're gonna be more detailed. In here, understanding why we execute that elbow, right? Okay, Carol? So don't worry about that. It's why we need to practice in that elbow. So you look at application. If I was in a fight and somebody pushed here, we're not gonna fight back. We collapse that part and we hit them. That's the meaning, you need to understand it. The form over Zoom is look opposite. You gotta not worry about doing the form wrong. I send you the video clip of Sifu teaching somebody here privately, so you have put it on TV, you can see it very clear, right? So the idea of this is like that. Move the elbow, the guy push here, I move to the side, I hit them. I move to the other side because he pushed here. Well, that is more important than the motion of the form, right? We're not worried about the form. The same with Francesco. Francesco do this, block, pull chop, hit, poop, hit, block, strike. You're not worried about the move, Francesco. You forgot it, mix up, no problem. So we can send you the clip of Jonathan do it here on the video inside so you can see it easy, right? So over Zoom, what we want to learn is learn application. Yeah, we're learning what is that move for. That's the difference. We cannot copy the motion over the Zoom because
They're not looking easily, right? They look mirror, right? That's why not worry about that part. Don't worry about that. I understand that you understand. Ooh, I do this. I use my elbow. I know why. I'm pulling punch. That's more important that you try to be copy the motion. The motion, you just look at the video, right? Yeah, look at this. Will make you even more confusing, right? But don't worry about that part. Okay? All right. I go back here. Now, well, let's go back to the way what we're using. So when you are in, let's say, jisao, we talk about the fight, okay? Both my hand up, and I have both hand to somebody's hand like this. Let's say I go to, I do a little bit of the hand-to-hand and stuck both hand with band, okay? Who actually have a lot of strength. So that person puts the hand in. Well, he push it in and don't push back, right? He put this one in, you try to do this, yes? That's where your chumkyu teach you. Your chumkyu teach you like this, both hand, right? Let's say you have a both hand fight with somebody. One person, when they push you, it's normally when they push like this. One of their hand will be unbalanced, isn't it? They're gonna have your right hand really strong, the left hand weak. So the way we do it, he push strong on this, I let him has it, and I use this, yeah? I use it because I know his hand the other side. When you push one side, this side is weak. So for us, if somebody puts this, I let him has it. I use an elbow to beat him on this side, and then I hit them, right? This is exactly when you guys learning the chumkyu, right? Chumkyu teach you like that. Now we'll talk about this hand. If he pushes this hand, I'm not to resist it. I collapse it, and I use this to actually try, right? That's why you have chumkyu. That's why you have chumkyu, right? Okay, whoever learn jisao, then when we get to the hand like this, foksao, this. Okay, this is my foksao, right? So same thing. If you push this hand in foksao like this, I will let you win, but I'm using this to track you, yes? There you go. And then I will be hit you with this hand. That is chumkyu. That's how you apply your chumkyu, right? So chumkyu apply in the fight, on the street, it's just normal fight. You can apply that when you jisao, you hold somebody's hand, he push this side. Don't fight it, you let him has it, and then you go overtake this hand by the elbow, yes? When you go over, you trap them. I go this way, so you see when I'm trapped them, I really use an elbow against his chest, yes? So he pushed it, I trap them, I use my elbow against his chest, yes? I'm not just trapped right here and let him push you, you don't want to do that. You want to be, he pushed my folks out, I'm collapsing, I use my elbow. Now my elbow take him, trap him, my back hand, I can do that to his face. I can punch him, whatever I wanted, right? He pushed it, I make him down. That's the meaning of jisao, yeah? We're using chumkyu. Yeah, that's more important, right? Okay, so there you go. So you have that part in the fight, you can use that part. You can use that part in the fight, yes? Okay, so that is, this is the move like that. Okay, so go back. Yeah.
If I'm learning jisao or fighting someone like David who's way stronger than me, how would I know which side is his weaker one? Because he's, you know, we started already. So
how do you know which side is stronger? All right. When you come here, Francesco, you learn like this. You gotta play some practicing like this. Okay. You have both hands like this. You go both hands. One person push you this hand, you push him that hand. One person put this hand, you push him this hand, right? Okay? Because it's normally, if you come to the person, if somebody push me both hands at the same time, I will pull him in and I hit them, right? Yes? But if you get a little bit like this, okay, we're gonna practice that to feel. Okay? So let's say people put the shoulder. They put the shoulder this way, you go with this way. He pushed his shoulder this way, I hit him here, right? So you want your body work like that. That's the same in chumkyu. If he put both of my shoulder, if he put both of your shoulder, then I will turn both. So he's gonna fall there, right? Yeah? Yeah. So if he puts both my hand, I'm gonna move like this. I let him go, I hit him back, right? Yeah, there you go. But now we're talking about when we go to the fight in Wing Chun, we both hand to the person. He pushed me here, I hit here. He pushed me here, I collapse, I punch him there. Yeah? We don't want him to put both hands. If he put both hands, I will move like this. The guy go here, and then I punch him, right, Francesco? I'm not gonna try to resist him, right? And of course, if you're stronger than him, right, you don't need to learn Wing Chun, you just push him, right? But this talk about when you go to him, a person normally push this way, they normally forgot about this hand, right? That's why Wing Chun will learn that it pushed me here, really strong. I will collect this hand and I do this. Remember, I do this with my body turned, right? I don't do this by in front of him. He's strong. So he do this, I move, I hit them, right? He turn this, I move, I hit them. So that's called Chun Q, right? Yes? So that's what we want to do, right? So yeah, so in the form, you gotta learn that, okay? All right, so we learned some of the technique of both hand combined, okay, is that where Chun Q start teaching, right? So, for example, when you learn, you notice the first part, when you learn Si Leng Tao, you learn single hand a lot. Bong, it's only one hand. Gan Sao, it's only one hand. Tan Sao, because it's the same like we first learned karate move, only one move at a time, right? When you go to Chun Q, we need both hands. A block comes with the hip, yeah? So we ask you more now. The block comes with the hip. So now they get in a lot better. The block, we don't block and hit. Well, block comes with the punch. Ganda, ganda, ganda. Yes? All right. The guy hit me from here. I'm block, his block, I chop him, right? Yeah? Man Sao. Man Sao, yeah? Begin, you learn only one block. Now I learn both. I learn both. If any time a person attack us, we do one block and one hit. One block, one hit. One block, one hit. You start and combine both hand hopping, and if you're even better, you actually adding the kick in there, right? For example, Kan Sao, good. But then when I do Kan Sao and I do front kick, it's even better. So when you guys apply that Kan, Kan Sao block, Kan Sao block, front kick. Yes? There you go. Okay, so you notice in Wing Chun like that. First, teach you one hand. Second, combine both hands. Third, hand and leg together. Yes? Well, until when you get both hand and leg together, your Wing Chun become good now. The guy kicking me, I will do this. It's hard to move them together. But you go Kan Sao as you do front kick to his other leg. Yeah? So we'll practice that. From here, get to this. Yes? If he kicking you, you block him and hurt. But if you block and kick him, the second when he actually get to my hand, shoot, he got my kick. My kick kick right to his leg. The leg that he's not kicking, I kick that leg low. So he will fall down, right? We want to kick them right to the knee part where the guy person kick you, he put a lot of weight on this. All right, he put a lot of weight in the back. We want to kick right to that leg, yeah? Because when he do this, when you kick him somewhere about here, you will get his leg or the groin or your body, he cannot even jump anywhere because his body is right there, right? So you gotta do this, block, kick, that's it. Yeah, Kan Sao, block, kick. We'll practice that because normally people are very hard to do that. They're gonna block first and kick, it's too slow. Want to go together. Yeah, Kan Sao, front kick. Kan Sao, front kick. And the kick have to go low. We'll practice like that. Yeah, Kan Sao, front kick. So try to go. Yeah, we'll practice on Jesco. It's hard, but hey. Yeah, it's hard to do the combo like that. Kan Sao. If you're confused, Jesco, if you're confused, thinking of this. Kan Sao. Tan Sao, front kick. Yeah, do that. Tan Sao, front kick. Can you do that? Can you do Tan Sao with front kick?
Do you keep with the same legs? Not like the same legs, same side?
I will be my Tan Sao to clear the kick. Then I kick with this leg to his leg. So my front kick will be lined up with my Tan Sao here. Here, this. Right? My Tan Sao with that kick. So I want to be the same arm with that leg, right? Try that. Yeah, try that. Straight with the front. I face this way. Francesco can see easy. I'm using right hand on top, Gan Sao on the bottom. My right hand, my right leg. Okay, right hand, right leg together. Yes. That's it. The hand in front, shoot, that kick. All right, yeah? Do that, shoot, left, right, how you do that? All right. When you understand that, watch this. Okay, watch this. Hands out. Yes? Hands out. Okay, watch this move. I don't know where that come from. Can, from can. See this, you see that. Hands out. Hands out is a block. When you block like this, the person who kick you, it pretty much up close to where your elbow. When your bottom hand got in touching, you turn up, you catch him to your hands out. It's gonna be like that. I'm block, I wrap him leg in, wrap the leg, my front hand become throw them, right? Shoot! So that throwing like this, you see the hand throwing him off balance? It's also the one that chop him to the neck, right? That also chop him to the neck. So I do this, then I lift his hand, I wrap his leg. This hand now go push him to his neck, both hands. He's gonna drop down, right? Yes. When we come back, we'll practice outside the grass or the mat. You will practice the move. That person will fall down. Block and fold. So look at my footwork when I go on this side. I do canto and I go to this. Same leg. If I go slowly, it looks like a Tai Chi move. Canto, step forward. Yeah? It's like that. Yeah. Jonathan, do it right. Can and lift. The bottom hand lift to catch his leg. The front hand here, fax out, push it, throw it. Yes? You step right to him. Yeah? It's too bad nobody here, otherwise I can do demo here. You can see. Hands out. Like that. Okay? This move again, the kick. A lot of those move again, the kick. Yes? A lot of move again, the kick. Take this, throw it. Yeah? You learn from many, many. Right? But the hands out, and then you go lift. He kick you, boom, and then you lift it. His legs now hook on your arm. The tansou now, arm catch. Wing Chun don't catch arm like this, like Muay Thai, hold the guy very hard. We don't want to hold him hard because when you wrap the leg, you hold it hard. His hand come in, my hand beats. Right? That's what Wing Chun will do this. You want to block and lift your hand. His leg is stuck on your hand. Your hand still loose like this, so it protect your face, and then both hand now, throw him, right? So that's the moves. You gotta cancel, throw him off balance. Okay, so you learn that move. Can, turn to throw, yeah? The other side, can, go to throw. Yeah? So when you do the move, later on you see in the air, we're gonna go that with partner, yeah? Cancel, throw. Throw technique. This is cancel, catch, throw. Yeah? Learn some move like that. It's very important. Okay? But this is some basic move. You have an elbow, like Jonathan just do. Catch, wrap his head, elbow his leg. That even also very aggressive, right? Aggressive as well. Okay? But again, right now we catch it, we step like this, the guy fall off balance. The Wing Chun like to be just throw the guy off balance like that. Yeah? Okay, so we practice some of the double hand move, important that we use a lot. Okay, we learn Kan Sao is one. You learn Huan Sao is two. Huan Sao is mean like that. I start here, I see thing coming, we bring your hand up, protect your face. That's why we have Tan. And then the bottom hand protect a lower part of your body. I was here, he kick it, I moved it here, because I'm not sure he kicked me low or he kicked me high. So the front hand drop to protect your chest down, and the front hand turn to protect your face. So this is called Huan Sao, yes? Okay, hand like this. Huan Sao. Huan Sao, yeah? When you do the Huan Sao, you don't think, you know, I'm gonna smack my hand to his leg. No, hand cannot beat legs, right? So when you print it, doesn't mean I involve my hand and I knock his legs away. It's not like that, unless you are very big and strong, the person kick, it's like they're thrown very, very, very weak. Then you can do that. But Wing Chun thinking of the person fight with you stronger than us. That's why we need Wing Chun. Meaning, when he kick, I turn it away from his kick, yes? I protect myself, but also I'm rotating away. I'm not come to his leg and do this. That's why some move I do this, and people on the internet say, oh no, gonna break your leg, break your arm. No, we don't hit the leg. We rotate your body. They can't come right here. They can't come right here. I'm rotating away, right? Because when Ben throw the kick like this, it's pretty strong. I'm not gonna put your arm for Ben to kick, right? But when Ben throw the kick, I'm rotating. So you actually turn as you use your hand, right? That's why the Wing Chun pretty soft. If I do the same move, but I'm doing like this. Yeah, that's when I'm fighting with him. That's where I try to use my arm to actually block the leg. No good? No. We just try to rotate it. Yeah? That's why the one so meaning I move it away. So if you look it down to the leg, you can see I move it away, right? It's like that. Okay? I don't stay here and bring my hand and try to hit the leg. Well, that be careful, right? So to get this technique correct, when you get in here, you get a partner. Yeah? You get a partner, I pretend I stay here. When Ben kick in here, if I put my arm and I stay in one spot, that my technique wrong. He kicking hard, I'm hurting. But if you do this, I stay here. When Ben kick in. Okay, you see my body? If I take my hand, you see, notice I'm moving away from the kick, right? I did not stay there and block. So number one, your body, it rotate. Yes, your body rotate. Number two, at the body rotated, your hand, it throw your hand out at the extra layer. So if he actually still hit you, it's not much because your body is already away from that angle. Yes? Does that make sense? So this is when you again the kick. Don't think, you know, I stay here, Sifu, and then when man kick, I do this. That's why people normally think we're gonna break the guy's leg. No, it's not. You cannot break the guy's leg. If you are small, you don't want to go like that and hurt yourself. People do this will be like a black belt, few degree black belt karate, and break the guy's leg because they see it, you are not good at kicking, right? You can do that. But really, Wing Chun don't teach you that, okay? They teach you like that. You're going to make a mistake when somebody's strong, a Muay Thai person, a black belt karate, a black belt taekwondo, a black belt kung fu, they're very hard kicker. You bring your hand like this, you're gonna break your arm, right? So careful. In Wing Chun, we teach you to be yielding his force away. Bong Sao, I'm yielding his force away, I hit him. I'm not smack my elbow to his hand, right? That's why people normally thinking of, it look like we do the elbow, we hit him. No, it's not. We move it away. That's how we learn, we move it. That's why the form you have Chun give this. Okay, you got punched, I move it, I knock his force away from my body, yes? I'm not do this. I'm not it forced to that way. Yeah? So you want to do a technique like that. Quan. Yes? Quan. Yes? Quan. Good. Now, after you understand the Quan Sao, after I do this, good. What next? I turn to Popeye. Now this is really a hitting hard because after I rotate it like this, I move in. Now you can push it really hard this way. All right, he's already like this. Okay, this one, you can go straight and push him. Okay, is that very powerful? Huan, Popa. Yeah, Huan, he called to us, Bubai Bopan, Popeye. Now, he's gonna fall, right? Yeah, that one's strong. But the first block is not. First block is rotated and Popa. Okay, learn that, right? Yes. So, now, when you understand Quan Sao, who learn kicking, put the kicks in. Quan Sao, all right. So you have two way. Way number one, no kick, move it away from the circle, yeah? Use the circle and move like this. And then hit them with the hand. Okay, well, Carol will do that. Whoever learn Chun Kyu, all right. Now, I don't need to move. But as soon as you turn to Quan Sao, you make sure you bring your side kick. And that side kick have to break the guy's leg, hit his leg before his leg touch your hand. Careful. Because he bring your leg up to your hand, up to your neck. I do low kick with my Quan Sao. Okay? So the logic like that, if somebody, let's say Jonathan gives you all the kick to my neck, right? So you hit, you throw the kick to my neck. If I bring my leg up, I kick your face, I am slower than Jonathan, right? Because he doing the high kick and I do the high kick. So the Wing Chun say, don't do that because he kick first and you do high kick. I kick after, I have to go low kick, so my kick come faster, right? That's why when you do Khoan Sao, he do high kick, I do this. Okay, so I just do low down to break his leg with my hand block, yes? That's why the technique Khoan Sao like this. Elbow, Tan Sao, and push. Yes? Like that. Good. So when you get practice like this, okay, facing this way, he kick it in, I do Khoan. And I do side kick, push him. He's gonna fall down. After he fall down on the floor, we're gonna chase him forward. We're gonna chase him forward. We're not gonna be doing like one kick, he fall down, wait for him to get up. No, no. So a Wing Chun, we go in, good, come in close. We have to come in close because the Wing Chun is the close fighting, right? So if I stop his attacking, he fall on the floor, I must come in close in to finish the fight. Okay? Alright? Or in self-defense is different. I mean, you don't want to fight. You just want to be get away from that attack. Push him. He's on the floor. I run quick. Because when he get up, he's going to be more angry. Right? He's going to be more angry. So there are two ways to finish it. On the floor in the fight. Okay, good. But if he's a big person, he throw the kick and you push him, he's on the floor. You not intend to fight. Then you better be running quick. He on the floor. He get up, hurt a little bit. And now he get really angry because he didn't even expect to kick him on the floor, right? So this is one. Go away. Okay, that how Wing Chun fight like that. Or push him on the floor, take it off. Because he didn't expect that, and when he get that kick to the leg, he falling down. But take him a little bit, but now he's pretty angry there, right? So either you finish him first, or you just take off. Okay, don't stay in there, wait for him. Okay, so that Khoan. Go in. Khoan. Side kick. So when you do Khoan Sao, depends on the distance. If you are in the distance, you spar with someone, he in front of you, they need to go same time. Khoan Sao and kick, same time. And even when you kick this, you don't even have your leg even stretched. Your leg bend because it's very close. Yeah? Very close, right? So notice that. It's very close, I do this, right? You don't need to have a straight legs at all because you are very close fighting. Yeah, so do this one. So some of the move on the wooden dummy is like that. Kick with your knee bend because they teach you you are pretty close. And that's why we do that kick. Yes? It's like that, okay? Now, whoever go to tournament fighting, just say I facing Jonathan, and he's far away, he like to do side kick. Far away, so then now what happened is far, and then I kick after, yes. Now you start and go far, and you can do that move, right? So from far away, I go shoot, and then I kick him. So this is when we fight with somebody throwing the kick from far away, like karate or taekwondo. But normally on the street fighting, two person not to fight each other, then the guy bring a leg, I bring this, and I push him at the same time. That's why Wing Chun fast, right? There you go. But if people go for tournaments, a different story. You go with somebody who know how to kick, and you jump in, you expect him kicks, you block first, and then you do. So this kick is go after, right? But to be effective, kick right away. Right away with the block, okay? If I block first, then I will kick him, it's very strong, but I'm slow, yeah? I'm slow. After I block him, I bring my legs up, he might be block my kick as well. So that is slow. But if you develop the kick, right away you kick them, you always get that person. Yeah? And just same, I show you this. I show up with Jonathan the other day, or Stefan. I was like that, yes? People kick me right here, okay? So let's say, Jonathan high kick, kick me to the neck from here, neck from here. I'm moving away, one shot. And then I kick your leg, yeah? This is how it happened in karate, Muay Thai, whatever, we'll do like that. First kick is, when he kick me, one moving away, two. Now I break his leg, so that's the two move, right? Remember this, when he kick me, I'm moving away, I bring my legs, he runs in away also because he saw I'm kicking, right? So if you do like that, it's safe, but you are very slow, yeah? What we want to do is no. We stay in front. When Jonathan will throw the kick forward, I'm pushing. I push right in right there, right? You want to be pushed at the same time as his head. So when his leg about to touch my neck right here, go in, I push down. So my leg down, would my hand come up? My leg down hit that leg before his leg touching my neck. This is why we jump win all the time, because nobody expect you kick and the person kick, right? They always expect you jumping away, and then I come in, you jump. You come in, I'm jumping away. I jump in, you run away. Isn't how it happened, right? Okay, the Wing Chun person is a person who like to be, we can say, you like to be gamble. You like to be go for win, not running back and forth, right? That's why Wing Chun effective, yes? But if you take the Wing Chun fight and you go for a tournament and you do that, people would kick you out of the ring. Because they say, hey, when Ben kicked me here and do this to his leg, it hurt him. So they're gonna kick me out. So hey, don't do that, right? And that's why we become very, very nice when we learn in the tournaments, right? Yeah, but in the real fight, no? In the real fight, I'm starting in, and when Ben bring the legs up, I just bring my legs here, so they hit him right to the groin, because he do high kick, right? He bring the high kick, and I just bring my legs up, and just hit him right to the groin, or somewhere there. Hey, my purpose going to win. My purpose not jumping and then block. You understand? So when you're in a real fight, do we have to be careful? If I bring my leg, I shouldn't kick the person in the groin. Oh, no. I want to kick him here. No. It's not about what you wanted. He kick, I'm kick. He kick, I'm break. He kick, I raise my leg. That's it. Where do you hit? You don't care. You just go straight to his center line, which is hurt him from there. He do high kick, then he gonna be get kicked right here. He do low kick, he get to the leg, it doesn't matter. He do this kick, he get one from to the other leg. That's all Wing Chun want, okay? Yeah? To be specific what leg to kick where, we don't need it. If you wanna be so precise, you are very slow. Does that make sense? You wanna be fast in Wing Chun. That's why we call reaction. Okay, you good? Yeah. All right, you good? So some of those move. Because I'm talking a bit more on the kicking, because when you come here, we do a lot of T-Sau, we didn't kick a lot, yes? So it's good when you go on Zoom, we understand a little bit of combination, how to actually develop hand and kick together. We don't like to kick in Wing Chun, but if you kick, you kick right, hand, leg together, yes? The guy do high kick, I do low kick. The guy do this, I break the other leg, simple, that's it. I don't wait until he's clear, he's attacked, and my turn. Yeah, not like that, because it's safe and it's slow. Yeah? We want to be fast and finish the fight. So we develop that. It's training to be, we kick, if he kick, we kick them. Yeah? Right away, so then we can stop them. Okay, good? All right, good. Back in line. All right, foot together. Hands up. Okay, bow.